Good evening, good afternoon, and maybe good morning. I'm not sure about the good morning. My name is Jacob Katuva. I'm a PhD research student in the University of Oxford. I'm going to present on one of the catalyst projects under UPGro. The project is titled Groundwater Risks and Institutional Responses in Kwale County. This project was conducted in collaboration with the Government of Kenya agencies like the Water Resources Management Authority, the Water Service Regulatory Board, the Ministry of Water and Environment and Natural Resources, and also the county and national level administration in Kwale, also the Water Resources Users Association, which is a group of a community which comes together to manage the water resources. They were also involved. Also, University of Nairobi was involved in this project together with Jomo Kenyatta University, University Polytechnic of Catalonia. We also had Rural Focus Limited, which is a Kenyan local consulting firm. We also had two corporate organizations in the study area which were also involved in this study. One of them is Best Titanium Limited, which is a mining company based in Kwale, mining heavy mineral sands, and also Kwale Sugar Company Limited, abbreviated as KSCO, which is also a sugar farming company, which is irrigating 5,500 hectares of land in the area under irrigation, basically. The rationale behind this research was based on the challenges in the management of groundwater resources being exacerbated by the rapid population growth, growing extractive industry, especially the mining company, and the agricultural sector, which is what we have in the study area as the sugar farm, urban migration, lingering poverty, as well as intra-annual and inter-annual climate variability. The scope of the project basically covered three components. One of them is hydrogeology. This package comprised of development of a conceptual aquifer model, establishing a network of shallow groundwater level monitoring and weekly water quality monitoring at 36 wells within the study area. A full water chemistry monitoring of water samples from the monitoring wells was also conducted, covering the wet and the dry seasons separately. The groundwater poverty component covered a household survey of 3,401 households, and data from this socioeconomic study of the households was used to develop a multi-dimensional welfare index using 27 indicators. The groundwater governance component included institutional transformations in the Kenyan water sector, which were assessed through stakeholder interviews and focus group discussions, which were conducted with the Water Resources Users Associations in the study area. The reasons why we chose Kwale, basically the study area is found 50 kilometers south of Mombasa City, and lies astride the Indian Ocean. The population in Kwale County is approximately 650,000 people. And within the study area, the main source of water for the local population is groundwater. This was evident from the 550 hand pumps which were mapped in the study area. And they were being used for supplying water to communities for domestic use. They supply water also to schools and health centers. The hand pumps are tapping basically from the shallow aquifer. They range between 5 to 30 meters deep. Also within the study area, there's a mining company which is represented by the brown shaded area. I'm not sure whether you can see my cursor there. But basically, it's sort of in the middle where it's labeled at zone 2. That's why we have the mining company. And then the pink shaded area to the south and to the northeast of that area is the sugar farm, which is irrigating 5,500 hectares of land under irrigation. And then they also have outgrowers whom they plan to have approximately 4,000 hectares being planted by by sugarcane. Both of these corporate farms require huge volumes of water for operations. They have built 5 dams, which are shown as the blue polygons in the map there. But the surface water resource is not sufficient for them, so they have opted also to tap from the deep aquifer, of which they have over 30 boreholes in the area, ranging between 40 to 150 meters deep. That is cumulative number of boreholes which are being used by the mining and the irrigation in total. Therefore, this presents a competition for both surface and groundwater resource between the community and the corporate farms. The study area was divided into 4 zones. As you can see, zone 1 is to the south, where we have the sugar farming going on. Zone 2 is only the mining going on. Zone 3, we also have another patch of sugarcane growing on. And in zone 4, which is to the north, was treated as a control. Basically, there is no interaction between sugar or mine with the local hand pumps which are being used in the area. Some of the results that were coming out of the study, Oxford University developed a water data transmitter that uses an accelerometer that is placed on the handle of a hand pump and records the swinging movement of the hand pump handle, as shown on the top right figure. This data is recorded and transmitted to a central computer via the GSM network and monitored remotely. So these devices were installed in 300 hand pumps in the area. Previous studies also in Kenya, which were conducted, the pilot project was basically in Chuso, which is in Kitui, and the map to the right shows some of the results that were coming out of it. The water data transmitters have made it possible to spatially analyze the hand pump usage by volume and map spatial patterns, as shown in the map in Chuso, which is to the top right. The large blue dots show obstructions greater than 36,000 liters per month, while the small red dots show obstructions less than 6,000 liters per month. The water data transmitters have also improved the management of the hand pumps by bringing down the downtime of the hand pumps from 37 days to less than 2 days, as shown in the graph to the bottom left. This is basically because we are able to monitor these hand pumps real time from the office, and we can see when a hand pump has broken down, and we can quickly initiate maintenance from Nairobi. To the bottom right is a graph showing a usage pattern for a typical hand pump, which basically differentiates between the wet and the dry season. What we can see from this graph is the red bars shows the dry season and the blue bars show the wet season. In the dry season, there's a higher usage of water, while in the wet season, there's a lower usage of water, or other obstructions from the hand pumps, basically because there are other alternative sources of water the community go to. On multidimensional poverty, the welfare index was analyzed using 27 indicators, which was data collected from the socioeconomic survey, and the results show that people living around the main town, basically Ukunda, which is where we have a larger red polygon showing the top 20%, which is basically 80% or more. People living around the main town centers had higher levels of welfare index compared to the people who were deeper in the rural areas, which are majority of them were lied between 20% and 49% in terms of welfare index. From this analysis also, we were able to overlay the hand pumps obstruction data, and what we can see is the red big dots are showing obstruction in liters per hour, while the small green dots are showing obstructions in also liters per hour, but less than 50, while the red ones is more than 200. And this is data that was being collected from the transmitters that were installed in the hand pumps. In terms of rainfall recharge and hand pump usage, from the monitoring network that was installed there. Part of the monitoring network was installed by the mining company. The other one was done by the sugar cane growing company. And also this project was able to install its own monitoring network of the shallow aquifer. Some of the data coming from the piezometers, what you can see in the top left graph, the water level from piezometers and rainfall data is plotted on the same time axis. On the y-axis to the left is the water level, and on the other y-axis to the right is rainfall. The bottom is a common timeline. What is interesting from the graph is that when we had high rainfall events, we can see a sharp rise in water level from the piezometers. And this, after the heavy rainfall events, we have a steady recession going down to approximately around April, where we had a pumping effect from one of the boreholes, which led to a sharp decline in water level. And then immediately we have, after a few days, we had a high rainfall event again, and that was also recorded as a response in the water level by a sharp rise. The bottom chart shows hand pump obstruction versus rainfall. So basically, this is one of the results which is of interest, whereby we can see that in the high rainfall events around May, we have low obstruction from the hand pumps, which also supports that there are alternative sources of water that the community go to in the wet season. On governance transformations, basically, the governance changes in Kenya and also in the study area as well included a new constitution, which was promulgated on 27th of August in 2010, which allowed decentralization of power and responsibilities from the main government to the counties. This affected the water resources management as well as other departments also. We also have the emergence of a Water Resources Users Association, which are tasked with the responsibility of cooperatively sharing, managing, and conserving a common water resource. We also have new actors managing the groundwater resource, and this includes the corporate firms using the groundwater resources. For this case, it is the mining company and the sugarcane irrigation company. This research was also able to install, initiate a professionalized hand pump maintenance service provision to the communities, which is instituted through this research, and this offers service to the communities servicing their hand pumps whenever they break down. In summary of the key results and the next steps, a baseline assessment of the environment, social, and economic status of the study area was established in the study area. A longitudinal and interdisciplinary data collection was also envisaged to take place. So we did the first socioeconomic survey. The second one is planned to take place after 1 year, which is basically this year, and the other one next year. We also were able to have a collaborative engagement with the government and all its agencies, even including the local county government agents, which are responsible for water resources management at the county level. We also had on board corporate organizations and academic institutions, and also the community stakeholders. The next step in this project is basically include the following. The hand pump maintenance service model is supported by the National Government Water Service Regulator. Actually, it received a recognition in the year 2014 impact report on the performance review of Kenya's water sector. The other step that we look forward to is getting new insights into the spatial and temporal demand and risks for groundwater use by the communities, and also development of a groundwater risk management tool that synthesizes data into operational metrics to support Water Resources Management Authority and other stakeholders. Thank you very much for your time.